Hello and welcome to Game Time, and I'm your host, Jackie. Today on Game Time, we're going to be revisiting an iconic game of our youth, Candyland. Do you remember it? Candyland, the dumbest baby game of all time. You didn't need to know nothing except colors, really. There was no dice, there was no counting, there was no luck, there was no skill involved. All you had to do was move along the board and encounter a bunch of strange creatures from Candyland. So today, we're gonna check in with the citizens of Candyland and find out what they've been up to and where they're at now. So first up, we're gonna take a look at Plumpy. Plumpy was the caretaker of like Gingerbread Plum Grove, and he was kind of like a portly caretaker whose job it was, I believe, to pick up a bunch of plums that had fallen out of the tree. But he's so lazy and so hungry and has such a poor work ethic that all he would do is eat the friggin' plums and just became this kind of wheezing, exhausted mass who was just debilitated with sugar levels skyrocketing through the roof. So that's where he was then, and hopefully let's see if he's in a better place now. So the update on Plumpy is he inevitably got kicked out of Candyland for his horrible work ethic. He was booted off the ranch, if you will, the Candyland Plum Ranch. And he, for a while, struggled until he found his true calling. He got heavy into eBay and became the world's foremost authority and collector of celebrity Kleenexes. And he's now featured regularly on the hit TV show Pawn Stars, where he, you know, appraises celebrity-used Kleenex, takes a peek, gives them appraisals, gives his authority on them, gives his expertise. And if you were to ask him what his most valuable celebrity Kleenex is, he'd tell you it's his Liz Taylor. Next, we've got Mr. Mint. You remember him. He's long and gangly with sinister stripes, and he's kind of looming over everybody in his candy cane forest. He was some kind of woodsman just working out there with all the candy canes, and he was kind of made of a candy cane. So anyway, what happened with him was he became a champion barbecue judge, going around all these fairs and all the smallest backwater towns, judging barbecue, judging ribs, judging sauces, and wouldn't you know it, he's no longer long and lean Mr. Mint. He's over 800 pounds. Sure, Mr. Mint is housebound, but don't feel bad for him. He makes six figures per month creating slime content on YouTube, and he lives in a six-bedroom mansion, so don't be crying for Mr. Mint. Up next, we've got Jolly. When you look at Jolly at first, it doesn't look too bad, but when you unpack him piece for piece, very scary as well. Floofy pants and kind of the size and shape and consistency of a gumdrop, but with hypnotizing googly eyes that will give you a pit of dread in the center of your stomach. So the update on Jolly is he fell in love with a celebrity life. After his time on Candyland, he had a brief fling with Judith Light in the 1990s. And after that, he got himself an acting coach, and shortly soon after, landed himself the role of a lifetime playing the Dean on Professor Cody. And now he's got 5 Kids' Choice Awards and 2 Daytime Emmys. So next up, we've got Lord Licorice. Oh, you remember him. He visited you in your nightmares. Lord Licorice, the unsavory element of Candyland, the main antagonist. In fact, it was his goal to turn everything in Candyland into licorice, if you can believe it. Well, where is he now? Well, first of all, he moved down the coast and got heavy into tanning. Like, really into tanning, like, but not in a good way. In a way that, like, kind of makes people freak out. Like, you thought he was tanned as licorice guy? You should have seen him then. He was leathery and licorice out and tanned as all hell. Really hit rock bottom. Got addicted to plastic surgery, addicted to injectables. He had butt implants, lip implants, the whole 9 yards, barely recognizable. Then he started hitting the daytime talk show circuit, warning people about the horrors of plastic surgery. So if you see Lord Licorice around, you're not gonna know it, he's unrecognizable. Next up, we've got Gramma Nutt. Oh, everyone's favorite, Gramma Nutt, such a sweetie. Her and her dog Baz live in Peanut Acres, which is like a suburb of Candyland, basically like a bedroom community. Even though like she would say it's part of Candyland, it's like you have to take like a lot of transit to get out to Peanut Acres. And she's always bragging about her nuts filled with magic surprises. Well, it turns out everything wasn't all sunshine and lollipops on Peanut Acres. Gramma Nutt was a huge con artist. It turns out there was nothing magical inside those nuts. It was just regular nuts in a shell. Oh, who could have guessed? Well, she never came back from that. Everyone in Candyland saw the Dateline expose. She couldn't even show her face in town. But for Gramma Nutt, the storm passed and people forgot eventually, and things are looking up. She's been showing her dog Baz at competitive dog shows. Got a couple blue ribbons out of it so far, and apparently she's planning on breeding him and putting his puppies into the shows as well. Ew, dog sex. Next up, we're gonna stay on the Gramma train and visit Gramma Gooey. Gramma Gooey was an expert cake maker from the chocolate swamps of Candyland, right down by the chocolate bayou, boy. You might know her as the sister of Gramma Nutt, but believe me, the two aren't speaking and never were. They were in a long-standing feud, something about one of them crushing the other's nuts and the other one ruining the other's cakes. It was a long-standing family drama, and believe me, we don't have time to get into it. Well, with Gramma Nutt on the lam, Gramma Gooey could finally be free to let her cake business flourish, and did it ever. Oh my gosh, people started gathering in all from all over Candyland just for one slice of her amazing gourmet cake. But be warned, if you go and visit Gramma Gooey at her cake shop and she offers you a dark chocolate macaroon, do not take it. Those are not chocolate. She's a good chef, but holy hell does she have a disgusting sense of humor. Next up, we've got Princess Lolly. Princess Lolly resided in the Lollipop Woods, I guess just alone. And you know her, she always had her head in the clouds and she was kind of like a dreamy dreamer, kind of a new age flake, just following her nose and just kind of like falling ass backwards from adventure to adventure. Well, no one can forget when Princess Lolly stepped into the limelight and was on Discovery Channel's Naked and Afraid. After her brief reality TV stint, she gave up her royal ways in favor of the simple life. She's currently yurting it up in Lollipop Woods. Yeah, she's yurting it up, she makes her own clothes, and she's living off the land. And we're all real impressed. If I had that kind of palace money, you wouldn't see me living in a yurt. Now let's take a look at Queen Frostine. Oh, she was my favorite. The picture of elegance, just so perfect, sitting there in her gazebo, sipping tea, skating around on Snowflake Lake. Queen Frostine, oh my God. She was my style icon. And I think later on she was demoted to princess. Princess Frostine, ouch. She became a psychic, or so she says, and she won't shut up about it. And not only that, she charges $300 an hour in Candyland for a psychic. And nobody's into it. That's too much! Oh good, we've arrived at Gloppy, the friendly but kind of bizarre looking pile of chocolate from the chocolate swamp. He was neighbors of Gramma Gooey. I know everyone's like, oh, he's the nicest guy, but he looks like poo. Is there any way of avoiding the fact that he looks like a pile of poo? I don't even want to see what he's up to. I know this is like so superficial of me and I shouldn't be so like judgy, but I don't want to talk about Gloppy. Just I can't look at him. Let's move on. And finally, the citizen of Candyland that we're all dying to know, whatever happened to that guy? It's King Candy. He's the king of all of Candyland and he loves all the citizens and he's just the greatest guy. And you know, he throws these crazy parties, the sweet celebration parties. King Candy, you gotta love him. Don't have a bad thing to say about the guy. Nobody did. So the scoop with King Candy is, he's still the king and he's never leaving the throne. Who's gonna succeed him? Princess friggin' Yurt or Princess Psychic? No, he's fine, he's staying in power, he's got the throne, everything's fine there. And he's got a lot of other business ventures as well. A few years ago, he bought the Miami Dolphins with his good pals J-Lo and Marc Anthony. Sources say he's considering buying a hockey team now, which makes no sense to me. Everybody knows King Candy loves Wayne Gretzky, but he doesn't give a flying frig about hockey itself. Loves Wayne Gretzky, doesn't care for hockey. I don't think this is a smart business move. So that's the dirt on all the Candyland citizens. Come back to Game Time soon and we're gonna look into what all those pompous freaks from Clue have been up to.